Hi everyone, I'm Jennifer McDaniel. I'm one of the founders of Soul Abode, and today I'm sitting in my backyard, and I thought it would be the perfect backdrop to be able to talk to you about one of our soul care dimensions. Today I want to introduce you to the concept of surroundings. Surroundings has everything to do with your relationship to your environment. So I want you to think of all the places, all these sacred places that you live, that you work in, that you play in, and that you thrive in, right? These spaces should be highly energizing to you. So the environment is all about those intangible, intangible elements that actually contribute to your health and well-being, or in some ways, in some cases, can actually detract from it. I want you to think about places that you have gone to, or maybe places within your home that you just feel really good in. The places that cause you to tap into your creativity and your brilliance. The places where you're feeling like you're thriving. And I want you to think about all the different elements that contribute to that. There's beauty, there's creativity, there's a little bit of you, maybe a little bit of someone that you love there. You probably have pictures and the right artwork. You probably have comfortable creature comforts like pillows and throw rugs. I'm sure you have beautiful dishes. Just think about those sacred spaces. If you have a prayer room, what's your prayer room look like? Does it have candles? Does it have a Bible? What types of items are there to help you to feel more connected with the divine and more connected with God? All of these pieces contribute to an environment, right? And when the environment is thriving, all of the pieces are working together. However, sometimes we can be in an environment and we can feel de-energized. Have you ever walked into an environment where you just felt absolutely drained and absolutely tired? And besides the people that were probably there contributing to it too, because again, people can actually energize you or de-energize you. It was maybe just something about the environment that didn't feel right. That's because normally the energy is stuck. The energy is stagnant. So one thing that happens when you have stagnant energy is you have an accumulation of things that hold on to energy that no longer serve the purpose of the environment any longer. That can easily happen when we start to gather things into our home and our home becomes very cluttered. And so clutter means different things to different people. In my opinion, clutter is when you have something in your home that's just sitting there, that doesn't have a place and it doesn't have a purpose. Everything in your home should have a place and a purpose because it's there to serve you. And what happens is sometimes we start to feed ourselves by just accumulating things because it's just, you know, an unhealthy way of us being fed in a lot of ways. We start to accumulate things and then we have so much that we don't even understand why it's there. We're not using it. It's just sitting around. And everything that we have wants to feel like it's being given attention to, the proper attention and the proper care. So the first thing that you can do to get your surroundings dimension in order is to declutter your house. Walk around every single room and the things that are in that space, ask yourself, do I really need this? Do I want this? Do I love this? And how does it serve me? And if you don't need it, you don't need it. If you don't want it, if you don't love it, then it's probably not serving you and it's probably ready to actually move on. And when you let those things go, let them go with love, because at one time they did serve you. But in order for you to bring new energy into your space, you're going to have to let some things go. So it's all about the environment, right? Another thing that can actually shift your energy is the amount of life that you're bringing into your home. Do you have fresh plants? Do you have fresh flowers? Do you have other life forms in your home? Do you have fish in your home? All of these things can actually increase the energy and the vibration of the home and create an environment of peace and to support an environment where you're actually healing and thriving when you're in these sacred spaces. So surroundings is critical. It's a big part of your well-being. And I encourage you to take the time to dig a little bit deeper and to pay attention to how you feel when you walk into certain spaces, because there could be something there that needs your attention where you either need to get rid of it and you maybe need to just pay attention to it to see if it really is there to serve you in the way that you want it to. If you want to know more about the surroundings dimension, go ahead and click our bio You can click on our link tree because we have this amazing soul care guide that walks you through each dimension of the soul care wheel in detail. And in that particular guide, you'll get some tips and tricks on how to immediately upregulate your health and your well-being in this very important dimension. Talk to you later.